Okay, Kevin Dye Dye Painting. I want to make sure to get a video for you guys. Let me back up here. Sorry if it's a little shaky. Beautiful home. Absolutely amazing home, but it's just, you know, typical wear and tear. What we do, I'll just kind of hit the ground on this. What I'd like to do, of course, I would like to get in and repaint the trim in a similar color, if not a little darker. I've been using a little darker gray, and it looks amazing with houses like this. But so we hit the ground. First thing is we need to remove as much of this black as possible. I mean, every bit of it. In our bid also will include stuff like this, handles like that, sanded and repainted. I think we do a full service, as in all this type of stuff painted. I want it to have a very nice look. I don't do partial work. So all of this guy here is going to have to be cleaned of the black. It is definitely in need. Okay, so lights would come off. Lights are taken off. And we start our pressure washing the phase of the job, which is good 2 days, because we're going to need to actually get in and try to remove as much of this black as possible. My suggestion is, it's definitely in need. It's dry. It's definitely dry. So gutters would be painted as well by hand. We even do the brackets so that you don't have a big silver bracket. I don't know why they didn't do that prior. Again, full wash. Make sure everything is very clean. We use a wood brightener. We don't like to use bleach. It's bad for the wood, but we need to make sure to get rid of as much as that as possible. It's very important that we eliminate that stuff. That's what makes the house, that's what gives the house what it is. You don't want to have that stuff. So, okay. This would obviously be covered. All lights, again, taken off. Speakers taken off. Gutters and all this stuff would be painted by hand. We can match that color if you like it as well. When we do this process, we would also clean off the deck for you. So that's not a big deal either. This door looks as if it could definitely use. My suggestion on this door would be to paint it in the trim color, just due to the fact that it gets a lot of sun. That'd give you a lot of longevity. The trick is longevity. You don't want to do this every 5 years. We try to go 8 to 10 year paint jobs, so that's what we do. Again, all standard stuff that we see. My bid will include all this railing. The deck will be properly covered, so there's no stain on the deck or anything. But yeah, stuff like this, we want to try to get at this somewhat quickly, because of the fact that any longer than this, you're going to start seeing it go through into the inside. This one's pretty good. So again, I would suggest a solid paint on these outside doors. It looks like someone tried to actually stain them at one point, which is not conducive to longevity at any point, because it's falling off. Okay, so again, gutters taken care of. More doors. If you would like to keep these doors the way they are, we can as well. It's not a big deal. All windows would be masked properly, which is a huge deal. Definitely very important that we mask these off. I do not like stain on my windows. I like no stain anywhere except for on the building. We like to use a 3M film that folds out, a very high-end product. Again, all railing would be handled. All what we do is we usually paint even those guys. We take them off and we paint them a black so they have a really nice appearance. The building is in very good shape outside of the fact that it's just the stain. I'm going to go over your wall here. Okay. Our job would include this beam here all the way around, as well as the fact that when we do the work, we also send videos of our work all the time. So every day we say, hey, this is what we did today. It kind of gives you an idea of what's happening. Obviously through here, we would use an Armstrong stain. It's a big house. We would use Armstrong stain, which is an oil-based stain, great longevity. It is pretty much the best stain that we can actually get in this area. Okay, got a little bat damage up there. We could definitely put like a little netting in there to keep them at bay. again, this side, this is where we need to address, because this is the side that's getting, the sun is getting this one pretty good over here, and it's drying out drastically. I might even be able to get a fix in on this. We'd have to see, but I could definitely try. See if we can actually get a fix in on that. I'd like to give it a shot, so, because it's falling apart right now. So, yeah, so I'll take a look at that. I might even be able to give a fix on that. What I've often done is I take a block and I stain it, and I put the block on each side, and that holds them in place until you so decide if you want to actually change it or what have you. It's definitely a help. And, I can make those look pretty darn good. Again, same thing through here. All gutters need to be cleaned and then painted by hand. We do the risers, as in the wood risers underneath the steps. We do those as well. We do everything underneath the house. Lights again taken off. This door looks pretty good. Maybe just a cleaning, and I would suggest just a coat of varnish, a cleaning and a coat of varnish, so that it remains in place. So that's kind of a good thing too. And that's our original color, because it's hidden under here. Definitely something we'd love to get our hands on. We have been very blessed with many of the nicest houses up here in Dorrington, and this one is a beautiful home, a nice lot. It would be a pleasure to get at this one. So my only suggestion too would be that these three main log beams, 1, 2, 3. What I would like to do is stain everything the normal way, even these guys up, do it normal. And those, I'd like to use a wood brightener that we've been using a lot lately, and actually put a varnish on them. So when you pull up, it looks like you have three blonde logs. That would make this house pop. But again, so that's pretty much what we do. Masking windows, we spray. Everything gets two coats. We spray it on really heavy. We back brush it, so it's a huge thing for us. I do not like drips. I want zero drips hanging off this building. So we back brush it really good, and then we come back and we fog coat again to make sure there's no brush lines or anything. Everything would be covered like that or what have you, or taken off the building, and that's pretty much it. It's a pretty simple process. It's just a lot of stain on this house, and probably a good 7 to 10 work days with a crew of 3 or 4 guys, because it's definitely a big house and there's a lot of this blackness that we have to get rid of. I can save these doors, which is a heck of a lot cheaper than putting brand new ones in, as you probably know already. So, well, thank you for even just the chance to look at it. What a beautiful house, and I'll send this over with my bid. Thank you.